What's the biggest plot twist you've seen in real life? Years ago, my company was slowly going under, so I was looking for other jobs. I got a job with another company and put in my 2 weeks with my manager. Me, I've been offered another job and I'm taking it. I'm putting in my notice. Manager: oh, well, we hate to lose you. Do you mind me asking where you will be going? Me: I'm going to company. Manager: shit. Me: manager, I applied for that position too. Me: I'm sorry to tell you that you didn't get it. Little town I grew up in had these two car dealerships on opposite sides of town. One Chevy, one Ford. They were bitter rivals. Attack ads, sheet talking salesmen, billboard wars, you name it. When the owner of the Chevy dealership died, it came out he'd also owned the Ford dealership by way of a shell company. No one saw that coming, including a lot of the higher-ups who worked at the dealerships. That sounds like the ultimate bored rich guy. Buy two car dealerships, have the managers sheet talk each other, and watch the fight. I graduated law and got engaged to the girl I had been with through university. We both applied for the same graduate program and ended up working in the same office in Canberra. 3 months before our wedding, I found out she was cheating on me with our mutual boss, and I broke it off with her. Long story short, it got really, really ugly and the two of us ended up in a very bitter court case over property. Canberra is a pretty small city and the legal world is pretty bloody small there too, and everywhere I went I bumped into my ex. It was beginning to seriously get me down, her too, as it transpired, and I applied for an Australian government overseas development job in Tuvalu, a Pacific island with about 11,000 population. It's quite a prestigious job to get, with only two positions offered for a 2-year contract on a rotating basis. I was successful in the application and moved on island to start my posting, to discover that my ex was the other successful applicant. I spent the next 2 years sharing a tiny office on a tiny island with the person that I quite honestly loathe more than any other in the world. A few years ago, I got invited to a friend's engagement party. They were throwing a huge bash because they were planning on a very small destination wedding. Later in the evening, my friend's fiancé takes the mic and starts thanking everyone for being there. "Sorry, Jen will be out to thank you guys in a minute, she's just having a wardrobe malfunction." He goes on to tell the story about how they met, how they were best friends, and decided to get engaged, and finished along the lines of, "We wish you could all be there, and that we could get married right now. So we are going to—" Out walks Jen in her wedding dress. 1991, I'm 19, just signed the lease for my first solo apartment, just got the first paycheck from my new job. I deposit the paycheck at an ATM, another first. I'd always gone into the bank to do it. 2 weeks later, I get my bank statement in the mail and see with horror I have only $1.87 in my account. Way wrong, I should have at least $200, I'd been very careful with my spending. I'm freaked, I came within $2 of bouncing my first rent check. I'm literally reaching for the phone to call the bank when the phone rings. It's the police, asking if my ATM card was stolen. I check my wallet and the card is missing. My job at a theater pub came with cash tips, so I didn't use the card often, and tell them I was going to call them anyway, because I was missing $200 from my account. "Well, we've got your card and your $200, so come down to the police station," they tell me. I can't figure out how they have my card in the cash. Doesn't make sense. I drive down there. Detective says someone, let's call him Bob, pulled in to use an ATM and saw a man acting suspiciously while he was using it, moving back and forth as if trying to dodge the camera. Bob says the man then left the ATM, got into a car, and drove away at high speeds as if fleeing. Bob then went to the ATM and put his card in, which popped out. Bob then withdrew $200, and then another ATM card popped out. My card. Bob's card had popped out because the crook had left my card in the ATM before speeding away. Bob realized he had withdrawn the money from my account and not his, so he brought my card in the cash to the police and reported the attempted theft. The detective gives me the description of the crook. According to Bob, it was a man 5 feet 7 inches, brown hair, round gold-rimmed glasses. I say out loud so, about my height, my color hair, and glasses like mine, before realizing Bob was describing me. I'd never deposited a check in an ATM before, so I was moving back and forth, following the instructions on the screen, filling out the envelope with my account number, punching the amount in, etc. I then forgot to take my card out and just left, because I'm a ducking idiot. I drove away at high speeds, because I was 19 and that's how I drove everywhere. Worried the detective might be annoyed, I didn't tell him I was the crook, I just thanked him, and left with the money I stole from myself. Somewhere in a box in my closet I still have the police report where I'm both the victim and the perp. The one guy I worked with was having a baby. He told me about his GF. Yeah, she's pretty big but she's amazing. She's the one for me. I didn't know him very well, but as he talked about the pregnancy and so forth, and I gave him encouraging words and how his life was going to change so much, we bonded a bit. His baby was going to be born right before Christmas. He missed our work Christmas party because his baby was being born. We expect him to be gone for paternity leave, but he shows up a few days later. I feared the worst, that the baby had died. It turned out his girlfriend was lying about being pregnant to spend more time with him. I didn't think much of it at the time, but the fact that he brought up she was fat for no reason must have meant she was so fat you couldn't tell whether she was pregnant or not. She showed him someone else's ultrasounds. They talked about what they would name their baby, how they'd handle taking care of it, all that shit. I don't know what she thought was gonna happen when 9 months passed and no baby. I guess it's good she came clean though, a more diabolical person would have faked a miscarriage or something. But that was seriously messed up. Shortly after the dude left, so I don't really know how he handled it. I knew a woman who was going through divorce proceedings with her husband. He was always argumentative and borderline abusive towards her, certainly always shouting and demeaning. Then, just as the divorce was entering its final stages, he very suddenly died. His autopsy showed that he had a massive undiagnosed brain tumor which had been physically altering his personality. His wife felt all kinds of guilty afterwards and took it out on everyone she talked to and lost a lot of friends in the process. My wife's uncle is an incredibly nice guy who absolutely adores his wife. We started hearing about marital issues. He was becoming more and more argumentative, and then he hit her. They separated. He harassed her to the point that she got a restraining order. He defied the restraining order and was put in jail. In jail, his issues got him a medical evaluation. Turns out he had a brain tumor. They removed it. He returned to normal and was released from jail. They're back together with him, back to his wife adoring self. My grandfather's funeral. He was always a fairly reserved and distant father as far as I understood. Would fit the stereotype of a northern dock worker who comes home expecting dinner to be in the table and then goes to the pub all evening via the bookies. Anyway, an unsurprising heart attack later, we are all gathered for his funeral. We are a big but close family, so we know everyone, including his friends. However, one guy turns up about the same age as my dad and his siblings who nobody knows. Long story short, turns out it was my grandfather's son. From another family. From another marriage. That went on for as long as his marriage to my grandmother. My grandfather had maintained two marriages over 40 years, having 7 children with my grandmother and just the one with this other woman. They knew about our family and kept away, and apparently my grandmother knew about them but kept quiet. Turns out he wasn't going to the pub every night. Was out with a friend of mine who ran into her dad and his other family. Damn, that has to suck. How did he explain that? He didn't. She saw him kiss the other woman and a kid yelled daddy while grabbing his leg. My friend yelled her father's name. He walked over and said, "We will discuss this later." He seemingly couldn't have cared less. It was a sobering moment of reality, to say the least. I used to call my tutor Mr. for the first 8 months of tutoring, just to find out she was a woman. Fortunately, her name was Miss Terrace. I once had a job interview. It was very early in my career, and I was trying to move 500 miles to a new place. I built prototypes and brought samples of my work. It was a 9-hour drive, but everyone seemed so enthusiastic that I figured it was a lock. I did not get the job. I found another job in the area and took it. 6 months later, they called and asked me to interview for the job above the one I had applied for. I was given an offer on the spot and worked there almost a decade. In the first few months, the people there told me the guy whose job I had, who would have been my boss if he hired me initially, had actually said the samples and work I did was beyond him, and he didn't want an employee who knew more than him. Well, I guess he doesn't have that problem, since they fired him and replaced him with me. What an idiot. If you find a competent interviewee, you should snap him or her up and then steal their work for decades to get credit with the higher-ups.